We'll discuss about one of the theories of sound conduction, the most popular being Bekesi traveling wave theory. This was given by Greg Wan Bekesi in 1961, for which he got the Nobel Prize. Now what he said was, the sound wave moves or travels from base to apex and reaches its peak with respect to a frequency and then decays rapidly. So what he said was, the traveling sound wave moves and then peaks at one respective frequency and then decays down. Okay. He also gave a tonotopic representation of cochlea, which basically says, what basically meant was that the cochlea, the higher frequencies are represented at the base and the lower frequencies are represented at the apex. Now every time the basal membrane moves, it is quite thick and rigid at the base and it's quite flexible and it tapers towards the apex. And as the traveling wave moves, at that time this entire basement membrane moves up and down. And at one particular frequency, which is representative of the sound stimulus, it shows maximum vibration. And this is the respective frequency which is represented in the cochlea. However, it is quite coarse. That means every sound stimulus will not stimulate one particular area of the cochlea, but it will stimulate a bigger, wider range over the cochlea, which is approximately at a space at a distance of 1 kilohertz. But when it is relayed on to the cortex brain, at that time it undergoes finer processing. It undergoes finer processing and you are able to differentiate sound. So this is also called as the pitch place theory. That is, for every pitch there is a place. Pitch is nothing but the frequency. So for every pitch there is a place. That means for every pitch in the cochlea there is a place. That is tonotopic representation from base to apex. Base by higher frequencies, apex by lower frequencies. Traveling wave which reaches a peak at one particular point which is representative of that frequency. So this is what is most widely accepted, Bekesi's traveling wave theory.